course, please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please be seated for the rest of today's announcements. The impossible question is, every year we spend more than 4 days doing this. What is it? Stay tuned to find out. Want to help local families in need? Does the singing of songs like Carol the Bells and Little Drummer Boy help you get into the holiday spirit? Well, bring a non-perishable food item to the winter choir concert tonight at 7 p.m. here in Baldwin High School. Scholarship Bulletin number 7 is out. See Mr. Hall. Check your Google Classroom account or look at the Counselor Weebly to see the latest bulletin or one of the previous 6. If you did not attend the last Outreach Diversity meeting and would like to purchase a shirt, please contact Jordan Dolly at 20dollyj@bwschools.net with your name and size ASAP. There will be a junior class meeting at 2:30 in room 110 tomorrow. All members of the executive board should be planning on attending. The Bioswale volunteer project with Ms. Babick is canceled for today due to the snow. Please stay tuned for a rescheduled date in January. The Special Olympics Club will be holding their first annual speedball tournament today from 2:45 to 5 p.m. in the main and small gyms. This event is open to all BHS students, even if you are not a part of the club. The entry fee is $20 per team, and you can register up to 6 people on a team. Registration forms can be found on the bulletin board outside of the main gym or on the Special Olympics website. Now back over to Ethan for the weather. Ethan?
Thanks, Bella. Today we have a high of 27 and a low of 19 with a 74% chance of rain. On Sunday, we're going to see a rise in temperature for the Steelers game, but it's going to be raining. Drive safely. Now over to Dee for the rest of the morning announcements.
Thanks, Ethan. The German Club will hold its annual gingerbread building party today after school in room 304. Teams consist of 3 members, and each team must sign up in room 304. For details and ingredients, see Mr. Hyman. The Literary Guild will meet on Tuesday in room 328 after school. We will take our yearbook photo, pick a new book, and have our holiday party. Are you itching to wear your ugliest holiday sweater? Join the Latin Club for their annual ugly sweater contest on Thursday, December 21st. All you have to do is wear your most ridiculous sweater and check into room 302 prior to the contest. All proceeds will be donated to the Make-A-Wish Foundation, and the student who raises the most money will win a $25 gift card. Looking for something sweet to give your friends for Christmas? Buy a hot chocolate grim from the freshman class outside during lunch in the South Cafeteria for only $1. French Club is holding a fundraiser this Friday in order to raise money for the victims of Hurricane Irma. Stop by at lunch periods outside the South Cafeteria, make a donation, and sign up to Pet Puppies this Friday. Tomorrow has been declared Star Wars Day at Baldwin High School. To celebrate the release of The Last Jedi, wear your Star Wars gear or dress up as your favorite Star Wars character. May the Force be with you. No lightsabers or other weapons are permitted. Now over to Jack for the jingle of the day. Jack?
Thanks, Dee. Today's jingle of the day is the holiday favorite of crew member Evan Laurent. Let's take a listen and see if you can name that song.
Put one foot in front of the other, and soon you'll be walking across the floor. Put one foot in front of the other.
That song was One Foot in Front of the Other by Mickey Rooney. An interesting fact is that it was featured in the Christmas special, Santa Claus is Coming to Town. It is sung by Kris Kringle to help the Winter Warlock change his nasty ways and become a nice person. Thanks for watching. Now for the sports announcements. Girls JV and varsity basketball have a game at Mount Lebanon at 6 o'clock tonight. The co-ed varsity swimming has a meet against South Park tonight. Tonight is the last Thursday night color rush game of the year, and it is the Indianapolis Colts against the Denver Broncos. And finally, tonight is the first time beloved former goaltender Marc-Andre Fleury is facing his former team, the Pittsburgh Penguins, as the Penguins take on the Vegas Golden Knights in a face-off of an opening series of a two-game season series this year. Back to you, Dee.
Thanks, Jack. Today's lunch is Domino's Pizza with your choice of milk. Today's weird holiday is Roast Chestnuts Day. The answer to the impossible question of, every year we spend more than 4 days doing this, is complaining about the weather. Seniors, there's only 103 days left of school. Keep hanging in there. That's all for the morning announcements. Have a great day, Baldwin.
Elf is a pretty good movie. Do I think it could win an Oscar? No. However, I think it's a fun flick that most people will get a kick out of. In light of the Christmas spirit, we're going to look at the reasons why Elf is so good. Elf is the story of a middle-aged man who was raised by North Pole elves. When he finds out the truth of his race, he travels to the Big Apple to meet his real father. This is one of those Christmas movies that gets played every year on ABC, yet, in my experience, never really gets old. There's just something inherently funny about Will Ferrell acting so stupid and innocent, especially when put up against his arsenal of R-rated content. It's a real contrast to Ferrell's typical work, and he nails it. This movie is universal. Most people, whether they're 9 or 92, will probably get a good couple laughs out of this movie. And that's its main goal, to make people laugh. It doesn't try to be It's a Wonderful Life, and there's no problem with that. It doesn't want to make you think. All it wants you to do is have fun, and it accomplishes that goal. From time to time, no matter what part of the year, my family and I find ourselves quoting the movie, whether it be through his innocent obscenities,
ow! Son of a nutcracker!
Or simply saying,
Francisco, that's fun to say.
I'd agree with IMDb's rating of a 7 out of 10. Overall, it's a fun Christmas movie for people of any age. This has been Ryan Peters with Mini Movie Reviews. Thanks for watching.